And this was one of those dream jobs where every single moment of it was actually a dream.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Dance Dish, where the dance ends and the dish begins. I am your host, the one and only Brooklyn J, and I am so excited to be here because we have some amazing guests. First, let's give it up for Jessica Walker. Yes! So happy you're here. Yes. And the sickening Sunny Walters. Yes. Sickening. Sunny, I heard you did The Greatest Showman, and I love the movie. I love it. I heard there were some challenges. Please explain.
Greatest Showman will definitely go down as one of my favorite jobs as a dancer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it starts, the bar starts very high for this film. You know, you don't go to every single job really wanting to be there. You know, there's usually something that you're like, yeah, I could do without that
thing. Yeah, you just have to get through it.
You know?
Yeah.
And this was one of those dream jobs where every single moment of it was actually a dream. We shot in New York, which is where I'm from, and I think that for me was a full circle moment. I grew up as a little girl in New York wanting to be a dancer, and here I was this many years later shooting a film with Hugh Jackman and Kael Settle and all these incredible dancers, right? Getting up to go to work every day was to go to set with these people to create this film. So it has a really special place in my heart because of that alone.
Right.
And then the celebrity cast was incredible. It was, Hugh Jackman was the dance dad you never knew you wanted. Kael Settle was very, her comedic timing was epic, but also she was very nurturing, so she was also like a mama. And we worked with the two of them the most, but you know, there was Zendaya, there was Zach. All of these celebrities were super like on it. They wanted to dance, they wanted to get the step, they wanted to be there in the room, so that was really incredible.
Right.
And then the cast of dancers was everybody I never got a chance to work with in LA that I wanted to work with.
Oh yes,
was
that
there.
Cast was sickening.
And I can't start naming names because then I have to name all of them.
Right,
each and every one of them
is so dope.
You know what I mean?
Unbelievable.
They've all done every job you ever wanted to do, and then on top of that, like, this was my family. Like, these are good people.
In one spot.
In one spot, yes. At one time, doing not this thing that's gonna be a day shoot, but like months of rehearsals and filming, you know? So, like I said, right, the bar was set super high. Everything about this film, the director, Michael Gracie, is an incredible director who actually knows how to shoot dance.
Yeah,
which
you could tell. You could tell.
Which is a thing, right?
You could tell, because a lot of people don't edit that. It's just chopped and it doesn't look right. That was sickening.
And then all your hard work, you're like, wait, where's all that that
where's
I was doing for that many weeks? Exactly, you know? So it was all of these wonderful things that came together for this one beautiful moment. So dream job. The challenge came afterwards. So we wound up dancing for this musical and also singing our faces off for this musical.
So you had to learn all the music.
Well, see, it's not like that in every musical, right? Like certain commercials, certain musicals, you can get away with lip syncing, you know? And you're fine, and you're good to go. You're doing all your steps, you're dancing, you're lip syncing, but your breath is not being compensated because of the singing, because you're just kind of...
You just lip sync, you're mouthing it. So you're not
winged. You're doing your thing. Michael Gracie, the director, really wanted people at home to be able to connect
and feel
that we were singing.
Yes.
So we went into this going into music rehearsals, learning parts for songs. Like, you're gonna be the soprano in this. Yeah. You're gonna be the alto in this. So that if the camera happens to come to you during this high note that's being sung,
it looks like
you are singing that note, you know?
Did you know that you were going to be singing for the film? Because normally you're tracked.
And there was track. Our voices weren't on the recording.
Okay.
But every single take we were singing live. I don't think any of us knew that because that's not necessarily a standard on musicals.
Do you appreciate now that he made you guys do that? Because when you watch the film, you kind of go, dang, it really looks like you guys are in it to win it.
Yeah. We definitely were, and I see what he was going after, and I can appreciate it. It's
brilliant.
One of the reasons why when you watch a scene like, you know, the bar scene, right, where we're singing "And We Will Come Back Home," I just got chills just saying it.
Yeah.
It's one of the reasons why you feel it the way that you feel it, because we were in it, you
especially
know?
With the incredible cast that you guys had, and all of you guys as one made it so powerful.
Yeah. And when you're singing those words, actually singing those lyrics, you can't help but be emotional as a dancer.
I was just gonna ask, did you cry?
Oh, absolutely.
Because I know during the movie, you know, we cry.
Yeah.
Like, there's certain parts where you kind of just get teary-eyed and choked up.
Yeah.
As a dancer doing those sections, were you like choked up?
I definitely was like, oh, I am acting also, you know? Yeah, it was doing all of the things. It was dancing, and it was singing, and it was acting. There were so many incredible moments that I didn't know were gonna come. I didn't know were gonna come up from booking this movie. I thought, oh, okay, I'm gonna be a part of this awesome thing. That's cool. And then everything unfolded after that. So, you know, I'm pinching myself because I'm in this beautiful dream world and it feels epic in the moment, you know? And I'm just like, well, where is the hitch? When is someone gonna wake me up? And honestly, it didn't happen until after the movie was shot.
Plot thickens.
We were on dancer contracts for this movie. Uh-huh. And we wound up singing, acting. Some people had lines, you know? And so we looked at our contracts and we were like, dancer doesn't really seem to sum up all of the things that we were doing.
Yeah.
And so all of us dancers came together and went to the union and we said, hey, listen, you guys, we were in rehearsals. You guys, you had reps on set who were watching us, listening to us sing our faces off. We would love it if we could get our contracts changed to performer.
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
And shout out to Teo James. He became the voice of our group to see if we could get our contracts changed, which I think took a process of like 2 years till we finally got an answer.
Did he get any backlash? Because you know, sometimes when you go on tour and that one person's like, we need more money, we need this, and then they're blackballed or canceled or whatever.
Yeah.
Did he get any?
And not that I know of, because it wasn't just him speaking his mind and us being like, well, I don't know about Taylor.
It was a collective.
It was all of us. There was nobody that wasn't backing him.
Because you know, that's what it kind of happens.
Yeah,
People's like, oh yeah, we need more money, blah, blah, blah. And then as soon as that person gets let go, it's like, oh, well, he should have. You know what I mean? So.
Yeah, no. We've all done the thing where maybe you don't speak up.
Yeah,
you know, because you are afraid you're gonna get kicked off the job or someone's not gonna hire you again or whatever it is. We had all moved past all of those experiences to this time be on the same page and to be like, no, there's right and there's wrong and this is wrong. Unfortunately, we did not get exactly what we wanted in the end, but super relevant to the moment, right? And to unions and to sticking together. Like, one of the things I think that I will remember most about this experience is how all of us stuck together to make something happen, you know?
Yeah. So on that note, let's toast to not being shortchanged. Let's toast to being an inspiration to other people who come in this business and know their worth.
Yeah.
Let's toast to that, okay?
Here for it.
Cheers.
Cheers. And it's everything you said was sickening. And let's cheers to Dance Dish.
Dance Dish.
How many is this for me, huh?